morning guys and welcome back. Just leaving Overlander, heading straight back to Perth to swap trailers for a Wando. I was a bit afraid that we'll get another trench last night, but everything was okay. I won't be saying the same thing about further down the road, because looks a bit ugly. But we'll see what happens. One thing for sure, can stop unless it's a proper parking bay, because the ground is so saturated in water, so as soon as you go off the bitumen it's soft. Didn't took long and the sun already disappeared, so yeah, we'll see what happened. Thank you. secondary ones, dirt roads and stuff like that. Like the one which my colleague has to go. At this stage it's open for four-wheel drives on light vehicles. Well, not cars, just light traffic. But apparently they got permission from the Shire to get the road train in. So we'll see how that goes. Affected at all. Road to Perth, it's all clear. Perth to Newman, it's all good. So for myself, it's business as usual. What happened here, guys? Up the cracks with tar. Oh well. Just bandaging.
Copy. You're clear to turn. And am I clear to send back?
To send back, sir.
Sending.
Faces with coffee and donuts should be on a road getting hard into these clowns. Time to make another coffee. Have a look at him. Have a look how he's wobbling. Come on. Send it. Launch it in a bush. That with a single axle caravan. between Northampton and Geraldton to Healy, up and down, up and down. It's okay for a car, no problem, but when you come with a bloody road line, it's a bit awkward. Should be around 30-35 k's from Geraldton. All right, arriving at Geraldton.
Exit the roundabout onto National Route 1. Continue on National Route 1 for 1.5 kilometers.
If you say so. Don't tell me that the council is doing some work. Jesus, something wrong with them. Ah, but yeah, the usual crap. 3 working, 4 sitting and chatting.
Exit the roundabout onto National Route 1. Continue on National Route 1 for 1 kilometer.
This is why Council and government can't do business. They got 2 supervisors for each worker.
You're pretty right, it's not 30 times that we're coming.
In 400 meters, keep right to stay on National Route 1.
Yeah, okay.
Keep right to stay on National Route 1. Continue on National Route 1 for 5 kilometers.
Here. Yes. Ah, well. Will be 2 more traffic light changes by the time I will pass the way these people move. tell him to jump out and go. He didn't want it. Now he can sit there. Oh, well. Come on. Keep going.
In 500 meters, slight left onto the National Route 1, Rand Highway ramp to Perth. Slight left onto the National Route 1 ramp. In 300 meters, merge onto Brand Highway, National Route 1. Continue on National Route 1 for 70 kilometers.
speeding up just to get in front of me, eh? You Muppet. These guys with these big boats behind them going to X Mount Coral Bay. I don't know. I got a mixed feeling about them.
He'll have to be a rigid
I mean, Coral Bay, X Mount, you don't have to go more than half a mile out to get a good fishing. And to tow such a heavy boat all the way from Perth to there to stop in every service station for fuel, such a waste. I'll do it different. I'll get a 3 meter Zodiac inflatable. Put it in the top back of the car, or in the top. It's light enough that two people can carry. Can launch that from any beach, anywhere you want, with a little 5 to 10 horsepower outboard. Just take the inflatable to the beach, take the outboard, and you go. And you are fishing. You wanna go to real deep fishing? There are so many charters there. And everything is gonna cost you a fraction of how much you spent on a fuel just to get there. I mean, this is my opinion. This is what I will do if I have to. I won't be taking my boat to X-Mount or Coral Bay. No, why I'm gonna tow that bloody thing behind me all the way? And it's enough that I'm taking it from home to the ramp, and I can it's only what, 10 kilometers away, and I can see the fuel gauge how it's going down. Nope, not there. So if I wanna go on holiday, and I will in the next couple of years, go to Coral Bay X Mount for a week or two, I'll buy one of this inflatable second hand, use it, come back, sell it, and I'm at a fraction of the cost. Yeah. So road works in Dongra. It's only 12 o'clock. Don't really feel like stopping for lunch yet. So I may go to Inyaba and stop there. Even if I want to, I can't stop because they close the car park where I usually stop. Yep. Another hero. Double tipper in the front of me, couple of caravans and a camper, and behind me at least 2 dozen more SUV caravans, campers, all sorts. Because they can't overtake since it's traffic coming. Up here. All right. like the army's on the move again.
Take a
All right, let's do it. Back to depot. By 6. Leave tomorrow morning 6:30. 7. Yeah, 7. Wake up at 6. Yuck. I wake up time, it's anyone. After 7, any one day after 7 is my wake up time. Well, I do have to do it when I'm on site delivering a bit early, but I hate it. And now, because of this delay, I have to do it 2 days in a row. I hate it even more. So... today. Until tomorrow morning when we go out again. Take care, be safe, and see you tomorrow. Thanks, guys.